You know the job, the work that needs to be done, but come next year, the dynamics will change in these halls. You're going to have new members, depending on who wins in the midterm elections. What then?
Carmina, you have 7 re-electionists who have a good chance of winning. You have 3 returning senators who are running and have a good chance of winning. You have another set of 3 returning senators who have an equally good chance of winning, although not seen this early. So it's not really going to be that much different from the Senate right now as we see it. In fact, if you go through the hallowed halls of the Senate, you would see pictures of the senators from the previous Congress, the current Congress, and the Congress previous to that. And it's roughly the same names you're seeing, same faces you'll be seeing too.
Is that good or bad? Elections. Is that good for you, bad for the people? How would you describe
for it? For me, it's not for me to judge, because in a democracy, you follow what the majority wants. And for anyone who is a candidate or is in politics and running for office, should always respect what the people, majority of our people want, and not for me to judge or decide whether they're right or they're wrong.
Mr. Senate President, we can talk about low-hanging fruits, just so you can help the President deliver on his promises. But what is the most important bill, you think, that when passed into law within your term could help define the nation's trajectory under this President's term?
I think 2 laws. One would be create more, because this is what the President has been touting the past 2 years in all of his foreign travels and visits. Selling the Philippines to different countries and investors from different countries. And number 2 would be the maritime and the sea lanes bills, which would seek to legislate and not only take advantage of the arbitral ruling, but seeks to legislate our rightful ownership over the West Philippine Sea in order to affix it in our laws and make sure that no president in the future or somewhere down the road would ever be able to change that particular position or point of view insofar as our sovereignty and ownership over the West Philippine Sea is concerned. Ms. Carmine, remember, the arbitral ruling is in favor of the Philippines, but we do not have a law that actually says that it is part of the Philippines. Of all the countries, I think it is in our interest to have such a law passed. In fact, I was suggesting to the Solicitor General about 2 weeks ago for him to file a petition before the appropriate court. I think the appropriate court would be the Supreme Court, but he might know better, to seek a recognition of foreign judgment here in the Philippines of that arbitral ruling, so that it will become, it will form part of the law of the land. And no president can claim otherwise anymore,
unless
it is amended. Yes, exactly. But then again, it hasn't been done. So these 2 bills seek to do that. If the Solicitor General decides to so file a petition for recognition of that foreign judgment here, then you would have 2, one by Congress and one by our Supreme Court. In both cases, they will form part of the law of the land.
Enforcement really was a big question when that arbitral ruling came out, because who's going to enforce it? But now you have, you know, joint naval patrols in other countries. We're joining it, and they're saying that's sort of an enforcement, but that's not enough.
No, that's sort of an enforcement, Carmina, but one major thing the President was able to do in a short span of time is to bring the Philippines back on the map, on the international scene. And for that to be heard, our position, our interest, what we are fighting for, to be heard around the world. I'll give you an example. Vietnam has a claim on these oceans too, on these waters too. Indonesia has one. Taiwan has one. In fact, the skirmishes between China and Vietnam are far worse than our water cannon experiences with China. But they're not receiving the same amount of attention and support as we have been from different parts of the world, from various countries. And that is all because of the President's efforts.
It's sort of like pivoting away from China, but towards the U.S. Do you see it as so?
No. Those who are saying that probably favor China more than the U.S. And those that said we are pivoting towards China during the time of President Duterte away from the U.S. perhaps favors the U.S. more than they did or do China. But I think the President simply favors the Philippines. And if it suits the Philippines to be inclined towards one or the other at a particular time in our history, as long as that is dictated by the best interests of our country, then that's what the president should do as the architect, chief architect at that, of foreign policy.
You think that we're becoming a vassal state, that it's just a matter of choosing which country to be subservient to, whether it's China or the U.S.?
No, I do not think so. Because, again, those who would say that would either be for or against a particular superpower. We shouldn't be. I am neither for nor against China. I'm neither for nor against the United States. I am for the Philippines and I'm for the Filipino. And whatever interest the Philippines and the Filipinos have insofar as a particular topic or issue is concerned, that's the position I will take. Whether it happens to favor China or disfavor China, whether it happens to favor the U.S. or disfavor the U.S., that should be the position taken by all officials of the country.
Mr. Senate President, in a matter of days, the President will be delivering his State of the Nation address. What do you want to hear from the President? What do you want him to say?
With any President, Carmina, the true State of the Nation. We want to hear from the point of view of the President how our country is. And number two, we want to hear from the point of view of the President what he wants to do for the ensuing year, what help he needs from us. It would be nice. It would be a good opportunity, a nice opportunity for the Filipinos to listen to our highest leader in the land once a year at least, to talk about these things. When I was younger, Carmina, I used to say the sauna is like is sana. Because oftentimes I don't hear what I want to hear. Oftentimes I'm disappointed and discouraged that some things were said or not said. That's why the sauna is sometimes referred to as sana by some of our people. Pero para sa akin, it may sound like a tongue twister. Sana yung sauna, hindi matapos sa sana at lahat ng sana natin, marinig natin sa sauna.
But Mr. Senate President, I asked you what you wanted the President to say. And as you correctly pointed out, you don't hear most of the time what you want to hear. So what do you think? You know what you want him to say, but what do you think you'll be hearing come sauna day?
I was not referring only to President Marcos.
Of course.
In fact, I was referring to the me during my younger years. Mm-hmm. I've learned to accept, instead of always looking for what I cannot see nor did not hear, I've learned to accept that we are different and the President has a different perspective. He may not necessarily be wrong. I may be wrong. Because at the end of the day, giving due respect to our President, who perhaps has more information available to him than I ever would have, or than you ever would have. And I'd rather that he be honest with us and tell us what he sees, what he feels, and what he thinks he can do, instead of simply expecting him to be like me, thinking I'm Superman or Batman or can do anything and everything, when in fact it is not at all possible. I'd rather be frank with the people too than raise false hopes, Carmina.
On the issues, for example, of corruption, the West Philippine Sea, inflation, we haven't even talked about that. Where do you think the President's voice should be at its loudest?
I think inflation, because that's the number. All of the surveys, everyone interviewed by any media outfit would tell us that inflation is the number one issue in the mind of our citizens right now. The issue on the West Philippine Sea would be third or fourth down the road. And the issue of services and readily available services, especially medical services, would be an offshoot of the absence or presence or gravity of corruption in our country. So these three issues would definitely, I'm quite sure actually, would be included in the President's sauna, given that these are top of mind issues our countrymen are facing and talking about right now.
But what do you want to hear in terms of inflation and corruption?
What can be done and what will be done? I have my own views again, Carmina, which I do not want to impose upon the President. And after nearly 3 years in office, I guess he would be in a better position to tell us what he can do within his term, what he cannot do within his term, and what he would like to start doing before the end of his term, given that we are nearing the halfway mark.
And as we wrap up this conversation, Mr. Senate President, what to you is the real state of the nation?
For me, the real state of the nation would be the Philippines reeling off from the pandemic with serious economic problems. We're not yet where we want to be, but we're definitely on the way to where we would want to be.
Senate President Francis Escudero, thank you so much for taking time out, being with us today and talking to us. Thanks again.
Thank you, Carmina. Thank you to our televiewers.